Hello and good evening to all of you. Today I would like to discuss two of the current related issues. The one is the great Indian bustard and the other one is the Minimata convention on mercury. So let me start with the Minimata convention on mercury, what it is. You must know that 3rd of December 1984 when this Bhopal gas tragedy took place inside Madhya Pradesh, the Union Carbide was the organization, was the corporation which was responsible for the release of this methyl isocyanate. And when this methyl isocyanate infected the oxygen, and you know, when this poisonous gas inhaled by the people, So many people died because of this poisonous gas. So the way here methyl isocyanate is, in the same way what happened with in the case of this Minimata. Minimata, actually it's a place, it's a bay. If let me say it technically, the Bay of Bengal is, so in the same way in Japan there is a bay and the name of the bay is Minimata. So what happened in the case of Bhopal gas tragedy, there is the corporation called Union Carbide. So in the same way there is a corporation in Japan, its name is Chisco. And this Chisco organization was responsible for the release of methyl mercury. The way here methyl isocyanate is there, in the same way the methyl mercury. And this Chisco organization poured this methyl mercury. It was, this Chisco organization was related with the, it was manufacturing some chemical components. So this methyl mercury, when it was released, and let me tell you that this methyl mercury was released by this Chisco organization continuously for 32 years in this Minimata Bay. So for 32 years, it had been, this methyl mercury had been poured continuously for 32 years. So what happened when, you know, everything has a limit. And excess of anything is more harmful than useful. So what happened? The marine animals, the fishes and all the animals, they got infected by this methyl mercury because it's a poisonous substance. And when the people who were living around that bay, when they started eating these fishes or some other, these marine animals, so the people, this methyl mercury reached inside their body, and you know, that's how this Minimata disease, since the name Minimata is related with the bay which is located inside Japan, from here this disease came into light. So that's why we say the Minimata disease, it is related with the mercury, and it's a neuro related disease. It's a neurological disorder. It creates a neurological disorder. You may be insane completely. You may be paralyzed. Your speech and your listening capability can be completely, you know. So this disease which happens due to this methyl mercury, it's a very serious one. Now the question comes, actually we know in the history what kind of effects we have seen in the case of this Minimata disease and how many people died due to this mercury. So therefore what is happening, that we don't want to repeat these kinds of incidents in the near future. So one treaty, a global treaty was organized And this global treaty is known in the name of Minimata Convention on Mercury. Its main objective is to how to protect the people against this mercury, against this poisonous substance. So wherever this mercury comes into existence, means if human beings are responsible for the release, let's say some mines are there, those are responsible for the release of the mercury. So this is the responsibility of that particular country, that please stop your mines, those are releasing this mercury substance, or any human activity which is related with the release of this mercury. So if we are controlling the release of this mercury, so we can, you know, means remove the problems, we can remove the Holocaust which took place sometimes back inside Japan in the name of Minamata disease. So this is the main motto behind this Minamata Convention on Mercury, how to stop actually the emission of mercury, so that we could get rid of these kinds of problems which took place in Japan. We don't want to repeat this again. Let me tell you that India has not ratified it so far. India is in the process of discussion, the negotiation is going on, but India has not ratified. Ratified means India has not officially approved this convention. So let's see how long this negotiation is going on. India is not against it, but you know, there are some norms, or those depend upon the countries, like, you know, this Paris climate is there. Some countries have their some advances, and on the basis of they are negotiating it. So in the same way, India has not ratified it, but I think definitely India is very much in the favor of this Minamata Convention on Mercury, because this problem is not locally, it's a globally problem, because this mercury can be reached from one place to another when it comes in the contact of the air. So you can have the Durand line between Pakistan and Afghanistan, you can have artificial border, but the air doesn't believe in any sort of border. If mercury come in the contact of the air, so whether it is Red Cliff or it is Durand or it is McMahon, it the air will cross, the mercury will go from one country to another, and that's how the people of one country or the other country can be affected by this mercury. So that's why it's a global problem, that's why it's a global treaty, and definitely India very much serious about it, and I think we will see the better results as far as this Minamata Convention on Mercury is concerned. Now the second is the Great Indian Bustard. You might remember when I was discussing this Wildlife Act 1972, because at that point of time Salman Khan came into light. Why Salman Khan came into light? Because Salman Khan was responsible for killing the black bug. And this black bug, if you see the Wildlife Protection Act 1972, this entire Wildlife Protection Act has been divided in six schedules. There are six schedules, and first schedule, the animals, those are coming in the first schedule, if animal kills those animal, so it's a very serious issue, because there is varying degree of protection which is provided to the different schedules, and the most serious one is the first schedule. The names of those animals mentioned in the first schedule, if you are hitting, if you are killing them, so definitely you are in a very serious situation. And Salman Khan violated this Wildlife Protection Act 1972 schedule first, because this black bug has been notified under the schedule first. And that's why Salman Khan has to meet with the 5 years imprisonment. If he had killed any other scheduled animal, so might be the punishment, you know, was little lower. But the thing is this, if any animal has been put at inside the schedule first, so definitely you have to think 100 times before hitting or killing him or, you know, whatever is there. In the same way, this great Indian bustard, let me tell you, it is also included in the first schedule of Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So even if Salman Khan had killed this one, so he had to go the same kind of punishment, because both of the animals are listed in the schedule first. So actually, why this great Indian bustard, and it is also listed in the IUCN endangered category? So why it came into light? Because, you know, let me tell you that this great Indian bustard is visible in most of the states, but the abundance quantity is located in the boundary of Pakistan. You can say the border place between India and Pakistan. In Rajasthan, it is very famous. So what actually started happening with respect to this great Indian bustard? The farmers, you know, nowadays the use of pesticides is very much prevalent, and this use of pesticide has created a sort of problem to the great Indian bustard. And what is that problem? Because when this pesticide was not being used, so if you are not using pesticides, so definitely there would be some insects, small insects will be there. To get rid of these insects, we spray these pesticides. Now what actually has happened, that when the farmers are using the pesticide, so insects can not take birth. That's why you are using pesticide. But you must also think in this perspective that the insects, those were taking birth, those insects were the food of the great Indian bustard. So you are protecting your crops in the name of killing these small insects. But you should not forget that those small insects were the food of the great Indian bustard. So you are saving your food on the cost of the food of great Indian bustard. You know, every species on this universe has some sort of importance. There is no any species on this planet Earth which does not have any significance. Most of the time, you know, I was thinking that why God has created these mosquitoes. Why God has created this butterflies or this housefly, what kind of importance they have for us? Okay, so I don't want to give lecture what kind of importance they have, but the thing is this, that every, you know, these vultures or these scavengers, birds or animals, they are the natural sweeper. But, you know, most of the time you think that what is the significance of it? So, you know, when you study in environment or in your science book, so you know that. So what I mean to tell you, that every species has some sort of significance. It may be the matter that whether we know the significance of that animal or not. This great Indian bustard, now the problem, as I have told you, that the way we are using pesticides, so their food, the food of the great Indian bustard, which was in the name of these small insects, these insects are not surviving because we are using pesticides. So when ultimately, look, you need to be alive. Struggle is the existence of life, said by Mr. Darwin. And when you are about to die, you will give your 100% in order to save your life, no matter what kind of obstacles are coming before you. So this great Indian bustard, it's an omnivorous bird. The way dog, you know, it's not, however the dog likes most of the time the non-veg, but it does not mean that the dog cannot eat the bread or chapati. In the same way, this great Indian bustard is an omnivorous bird, but it prefers to eat these small insects like the lizard or these kinds of, you know, means grasshopper or these small insects. When you are using the pesticides, when these animals, these small insects are not there, now what happened, that these great Indian bustard have shifted to eat the crops those are being produced by the Indian farmers. Being the omnivorous, as I have told you, so now, earlier they were eating the insects, but when the, by using the pesticides from the side of the Indian farmers, when these bustards are not getting the small insects, since they want to live as every other species, they started harming the crops produced by the same farmers. So now you have to take the decision whether to protect the crops or stop using the pesticides, so that, you know, the great Indian bustard could get once again their lost food. So that's why this great Indian bustard came into news, and let's see, because, you know, means one side, means the situation is very critical. So these were the news which I wanted to discuss before you. Thank you very much.